Welcome once again in the class of energy and environmental engineering. So far we have seen the air pollution causes and the remedies of the air pollution. So today we are going to see the water pollution. I am Mr. Sissogule, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department. Now introduction. The water is a precious resource and without it life is not possible on earth. Water is getting polluted day by day due to excessive and careless use, so the percentage of available drinking water is reducing. Basically, even though land has been or earth has been covered 70% with the water, then only 3% of it is drinkable water. Other is high in this salt content, so we cannot use this water. So amongst these again, some percentage of it is stored in terms of the ice. So very less water is available for the use. And once we are polluting this water, then again it will be there will be a scarcity of water, drinking water. So there are many ways which cause the water pollution, and the effect of it are very harmful for all living and non-living objects. The water pollution. So the water pollution can be defined as presence of solid, liquid or gaseous contaminants in such concentration that they may alter the quality of water. The water pollution is defined as the addition to water of an excess material or heat that is harmful to living organism or which impairs the beneficial use of water. So these are the two definitions of water pollution. One is the presence of this contaminants in the water which will deteriorate the quality of water, and second thing is the addition of excess material or heat which is harmful for living organism or which harms this beneficial use of water. Now what are the types of water pollution? First is the surface water pollution, so which is found on the exterior of the earth crust, ocean, rivers and lakes. So the water polluted from the oceans, rivers and lakes comes under the surface water pollution. And second is the groundwater pollution, so which is below the earth structure, that is called as the aquifers. The pollution of those sources called as underground groundwater pollution. So basically the surface water pollution, again so many things we are mixing with the water, so many things we are throwing in the water, acid rain is there, and so many causes of the surface water pollution are there. The same way groundwater pollution, again due to leaching or mixing these contaminants through the soil or by the this pervious layers of the earth, this groundwater can be polluted. Next is the microbiological pollution. So microorganisms that thrives on water and fishes that can cause illness to land, animal and humans. So this is the microbiological pollution. Then oxygen depletion pollution. So microorganisms that in water and feeds on biodegradable substances, they will cause the oxygen depletion pollution. Now, what are the causes of pollution, water pollution? The principal sources of water pollution resulting from exploration and production operations are, first is the domestic waste, then sewage system, that is solid waste, industrial waste, acid rain, oil industry and aquatic animals. So amongst these we are going to see few. So first, the domestic waste. So dumping of household waste into water comes under this category. So here you can see the pictures. So the waste from the houses, that is our the drainage from the houses directly mixing to the water, this cause the pollution. Again, we are throwing the garbage into the water, this also causes the pollution. And in case of this, the municipal garbage that has been collected by the household is dumping into the water, that can cause the water pollution. So these are the cases of pollution by the domestic waste itself. Then the sewage waste. So untreated sewage throwing into or letting into the water source is comes under this category. So here you can see the pictures. This sewage waste has been mixing into the particular water source. Then the solid waste. Solid waste causes the blockage of flow of water. You might have seen the examples. The blockage of nalas or the pipelines due to this solid waste, or the drainage pipe due to this solid waste, and that can cause to this water clogging problems in particular regions. It causes water as well as the air pollution also. So polyethylene, that is the plastic, is the main source of this solid waste, because the plastic do not decompose easily. So that is why this can be this could be a problem problem of this pollution. So here you can see the picture. So many this plastic is stored near the water resource, and because of which you might sometimes might have seen the storage of this solid waste produce the leaching. That is one it gets reacted with some substances and produce the harmful liquid, and that liquid is mixing with the groundwater or the water source near to it. So that is called as a leaching. So this is also cause of the pollution because of solid waste. Next is the industrial waste. So industrial waste containing paper waste, then rubber, metallic, aluminium waste, etc., is drawn directly into the water, which pollutes the water. So this is, here you can see this industrial waste. Even we have the so much problems of this sugar industry's byproducts which are mixing directly into the water. So in our region, that problem we have. Next is the acid rain. We have learned about the acid rain in the air pollution itself. So again, it causes by the sulfur dioxide emission or the this nitrogen dioxide emissions, and forms the nitric acid or sulfuric acid, and it falls on the ground. The same thing is mixed with the water sources and harms this water life, that is fish and so many things in the water. Next is the oil industry. So this is one of the major sources of this pollution in water, because most of the times oil industries or the rigs are located inside the oceans, so they cannot have the system to dump or treat this waste from this industry, and that can be mixed with the or it can be dumped into the this oceanic water itself. Then sometimes you might have heard the oil rigs are there, or the oil tankers are there. Tankers means the boats, so those are carrying the oil from one place to another. They may meet to the some accidents, etc., and whole water has been our layer of this oil has been covered the part of the ocean, which again harms to the this particular aquatic life. And then one more thing is there, sometimes the oil refineries are there, those are also on the banks of sea. So again, the waste from that industry also tend to pollute this water from the ocean, and it causes so many harmful effect, that layer of this oil, because the oil has the less density than water, so it tends to flow on the water surface. So obviously it cuts the oxygen supply or the air supply or the air contact of water with the or the contact of water with the air because of this layer. So obviously it affects the life in this ocean. Again, sometimes it form the it forms a layer of the darker color So again, the sunlight is not going into the sea, and again, because of which the aquatic life or the plants in the sea, they may get harmed. So these are the things which oil industry can pollute the water. So here you can see these are the layers. And one more thing, you can see the accident has been happened over here, and these boats are trying to extinguish this fire. Here again, the layer of this oil is, you can see the layer of oil. So by this, and here also due to burning of this oil rigs, etc. So obviously there is a pollution in nearby area. So these are the causes by which you can say that the air pollution, water pollution is more because of the oil industries. Then the aquatic plants. The water hyacinth, an aquatic plant, causes the pollution in water. It is long-lived plant which grows faster in water bodies and absorb all essential nutrients from the water, which is fatal for the marine organisms. It is known as the terror of Bengal due to its abundance. Basically, in local language, it is called as a kendal. Sometimes you might have seen it grows on the water and it covers the most of the area on the water surface. And again, same way, it absorbs all essential nutrients and from water, which is fatal for the marine organisms. So, else other fish, etc., those are not having this nutrition because these plants tend to suck all the nutrients. Next is the religious means. So most of the times you have seen that is so many people the throw so many things in the water, that is coconuts, then some sort of candles or diyas, etc. And in case of sometimes asthi visarjan has been done, that is ashes of this dead body has been thrown into this particular rivers. So obviously because of these things the pollution will be there, and this is one of the reason, major reason of the pollution of the water or water bodies. So what are the effects of water pollution? So first is death of aquatic organisms. Here you can see because of this less oxygen supply and all those things, because of this oil industry, we can see more and more big animals also cannot survive. Then rivers are changed into the dustbin. Here you can see this plastic is flowing into this particular river. So it is nothing but now is the dustbin. So because the pollution, there will be a shortage of drinking water, because we cannot drink the polluted water. Then increase in BOD. What is BOD? BOD is biochemical oxygen demand, as the measure of dissolved oxygen required to decompose the organic matter in the water biologically. So pure water has less than 1 ppm and polluted water requires more than 5 ppm BOD. So basically the oxygen freshens the water, and it helps to live this or as here written over here, it helps decompose the organic matter in the water biologically. So because if BOD gets increased, that is demand gets increased, so obviously it's increased because of this pollution. Basically, this pure water has 1 ppm. In one part per million, the decomposing is done in the pure water, but in case of polluted water, it require more than 5 ppm. So obviously, the consumption of oxygen is more in case of polluted water. Next, what are the controls of the water pollution? So stabilization of ecosystem in using water hyacinth to remove the water pollutants, that is kind of tree to remove the water pollutant. then using chemical methods like ion exchange, reverse osmosis, precipitation, coagulation, etc. And cooling methods are there. Then recycling of water, renovation, discharge, and reuse of wastewater can be done. So we'll see some of it. So stabilization of ecosystem. So the reduction of waste at source can be done, or treatment of the sources can be done. Suppose we are treating the water before throwing it, wastewater before throwing it into the water bodies. So obviously there will be a less pollution in this particular region. Then same in case of industries also, that water can be treated or dumped somewhere else, and then obviously there will be a reduction of waste at the source. Then burying of organic waste. So instead of throwing the organic waste into the water, we can bury this organic waste. Somehow it gets decomposed and then converted into soil again. Then fish management can be done, and proper use of water can be done for the stabilization of ecosystem. Then the sewage treatment plant. So as I told you earlier, the water can be treated before sending it into the water bodies. So here you can see the treatment center, that is screening is there in on the screen. The suspended material or the garbage in this particular water can be collected on the screening. Then this primary treatment, then the oxygen has been mixed into the particular this thing, so that the water gets treated properly. Then this sedimentation beds are there, so that the or this particles of the polluted particles can settle down and we can separate it. And this is the final treatment stage, and this filtered water can be through directly going to or mixed with the water that can be okay. So even this treated water can be used for the agriculture purpose also, and this all the sludge which is collected in this particular process, that is these suspended particles, then the retained on the screen, those particles are there. So all these things can be separately used for the this particular as a nutrition for the plants, etc. So that can be done. And this is the ion exchange method. So basically in this this is used for the reduction of the hardness of the water. So here you can see the zeolite like bed is there, and when the water is coming into this particular hard water is coming to the, on this particular bed, so what will happen, the particles or the ions of this hard material gets connected, or the that can be exchanged with the this zeolite bed, and we will get the soft water. So this way water can be treated. So this is nothing but the treatment of water. And again, this zeolite bed can be recharged with the NaCl solution, and wastewater can be brought out for the other reasons, or can be used for the other reasons. Then this is the reverse osmosis system. So here you can see in reverse osmosis we can have the multiple filters. So this is the pre-filter for the sediments, and the carbon filter, that is activated carbon, is there, which will attract the some particles. Then reverse osmosis membrane is there. So in this reverse osmosis, a very fine membrane is there, which will allow only the water molecules to pass through it. And with high pressure, this thing can be done. So only water particles can be passed through it, and that can be stored for the storage tank, and this all wastage can or impurities are out to the drain. Then again, the post filtration can be done even after the treatment with the reverse osmosis, and the purifier water can be used for the several purposes. So here you can see in many houses you might have seen this kind of system. This is nothing but the reverse osmosis system. This is on the bigger scale, and this is on the smaller scale. So here you have the three cylinders are there, and by using the high pressure that can be done, then purification of water can be done. So this is all for today's lecture. The reference for this today's lecture is slideshare.net. In addition to this, so many things can be done, like we have done in the or we have learned in the air pollution, that so many acts, that legislation, so many acts for the water pollution can be done. And right now the bodies are working, government bodies are working in this area. Then education is the most important part in this particular area, that we can educate the people, obviously they will stop this pollution of water and so many things. So we have to bring the awareness, like about the use of plastic, then what to throw in the gutters or the drainage systems, etc. So these things can be done by the awareness, education, and by putting some acts, we will get the less pollution of the water. So thank you for today's lecture.